Okay, good day guys. Welcome to week number 5 of your cookery lectures. So our performance standard for this week is to be able to demonstrate an understanding in performing mensuration and calculations in cookery. And the content standard should be to be able to measure and calculate ingredients in cookery. So after we finish this module, you are expected to measure ingredients according to recipe requirements and perform substitution in ingredients. Okay, let's talk about the pretest first. For the pretest, it's still the same, multiple choice. You will be given 10 questions. Please answer them thoroughly. Okay, for us to be able to evaluate kung ano pa ang mga needs natin. Then, for looking back, here's the direction. Read the statements carefully. Put a smiley. If the statement is correct, and a sad face if it is incorrect. So, medyo pinahirapan pa tayo. Pero, sige. Then, put your answer in the space provided. Okay, example. Number one. The abbreviation of tablespoon is TBSP. If you think that the statement is true, di lagyan natin ang smiley. Okay? Kung hindi naman siya sa parsing niya, hindi naman siya true, lagyan natin ang sad face. Number two, G stands for gallon. Number three, there are three teaspoons in a tablespoon. Number four, 1 cup is equal to 250 ml. And number 5, the abbreviation for cup is C. Okay. For our introduction, we're going to have measurement or measuring of ingredients according to recipe requirements. So, may sinusunod na tayong recipe dito. So, ibig sabihin, kailangan. If susunod ka sa recipe, susundin mo siya as is, ano, hindi ka muna, lalo na kapag beginner ka pa lang, hindi ka muna magdi-deviate, ano, yung magdadagdag or magbabawas or magpapalit, hindi ka muna magpapalit, except in certain circumstances, ha. Okay, listen. Measuring ingredients according to recipe requirements. So, accurate techniques in measuring are as important as the tools for measuring. In every kind of ingredient, there is a proper way of measuring. So, in measuring dry ingredients, step 1, rice and flour. So, dry siya. Now, step 1, fill the cup to overflowing. Step 2, level off with a spatula or a knife. With a knife with a straight edge. Kita niyo naman sa drawing, ano, so may illustration dito kung paano gagawin niyo. For flour, sift the flour. Use a spoon to scoop the flour and fill the measuring cup to overflow. Then number 3, level off with a spatula or a knife with a straight edge. Ano yung sifting? Okay? Ang sifting is ililipan natin yung flour. So, ano yung gagamitin natin? Gagamit tayo ng ginagawa itong sifting na ito para matanggal yung mga buo-buo. Okay, para matanggal yung mga buo-buo, ano? So, kita nyo naman ang drawing dito sa figure, no? Then, refined sugar. Refine this white sugar. Sift the refined sugar if it is lumpy. So, katulad din sa flour, sisift natin, ano? And then, spoon into cup until overflowing. Do not pack or tap the sugar down. So, paglagay pala ng sugar pag nililipat mo sa isang lalagyan or sinisift mo siya, so hindi siya dapat ano, hindi dapat daw the best way is to spoon the cup, yung pukutsarahin mo hanggang mapuno yung lalagyan or hanggang makuha mo kung ano yung dapat yung dami ng ingredients na kailangan mo. So hindi daw ito pwedeng i-top down yung sugar o isasalin mo. Siguro mapaparami kasi kapag ganun ang ginawa mo. Then, the next one is leveling off with a spatula or a knife with a straight edge. So halos yun din ang ginagamit natin sa ano, sa unang dalawa, no? Then brown sugar. Finally press firmly press brown sugar into the cup with the back of a spoon. Okay? Then level with the rim of the cup. Brown sugar should hold the shape of the cup when it is turned. Ayan. So maliwanag, ha? So kailangan kapag nilagay mo ng brown sugar yung nilagay mo sa isang cup, kailangan yung forma ng cup umaano siya. So kailangan ito, hindi katulad dito nung una, ito kailangan taktakin mo para bumaba siya, no? Then small amounts of salt, pepper, baking powder and baking soda. So step 1, remove the lumps in the powder by stirring. So haluin natin siya. Then dip the measuring spoon into the powder. And then level off with a spatula or a knife with a straight edge. Okay? Now, how do you measure liquid ingredients? In measuring liquid ingredients such as milk, oil, and water, you must use a glass or plastic cup with graduated markings on the side. Ano yung graduated? May mga marka siya. May sabihin, may sukat. So, step 1. Place the cup on a flat, level surface. Step 2, hold the cup firmly and pour the desired amount into the cup. And step 3, lean over and view the liquid at eye level to make sure that it is in the proper amount. So, sisilipin mo kung pantay siya, no? So, ang usually measuring cup natin, transparent siya, so nakikita niyo siya. Then, shortening. Butter, margarine, or lard. Step 1, fill the measuring cup or spoon with the shortening while pressing until it is full. Then level off with the spatula or knife with a straight edge. And shortening like butter can be bought in pre-measured sticks. One stick of butter is equal to 1/2 cup. Okay? So the proper use of weighing scales is before placing the ingredient on the weighing scales, make sure that the pointer is at 0. O walang mga dumi, para kailangan na laging naka-0 siya. Okay, our next topic is about performing substitution of ingredients. So, minsan, kailangan magpalit tayo ng ingredients kung hindi available yung main ingredient mo, no? So, kailangan palitan mo siya. Pero, ganun pa rin naman. Kung magkakaroon ng epekto, konting-konti lang. Ano? So, ito yung samples. Ano? Number 1. For baking powder, pwedeng 1/4 teaspoon baking soda plus 5 teaspoons cream of tartar. 5 to 8, okay? Barbecue sauce, 3/4 cup ketchup, 2 tablespoon mustard, and 2 tablespoon brown sugar. For beef broth, 1 beef broth cube plus 1 cup hot water. Broth, ito yung pinagkuluan, no? So, pwede mong palitan ito na yung sinasabi dito, pwede kang bumili ng, sabihin ko na yung brand, ano? Nor beef cubes, or if it's in cases na chicken, nor chicken cube. Okay. For breadcrumbs, 1 slice bread or 1/4 cup cracker crumbs. So, biscuit pwede. Then for butter, 1 cup margarine or 1 cup vegetable shortening, kung baking. Eh? For chicken broth, yan, sinabi ko kanina, 1 chicken broth cube plus 1 cup hot water. For unsweetened chocolate, 3 tablespoon cocoa plus 1 tablespoon butter or regular margarine or vegetable oil. For coconut milk, 1 cup milk pwede na yan, ano? So for cornstarch, 2 tablespoons of flour. Okay, for cream of tartar, 1 1/2 teaspoon lemon juice or vinegar. For flour self-rising, yung lumalaki siya ng sarili niya. 1 cup minus 2 teaspoon all-purpose flour plus 1 1/2 teaspoon baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon salt. For fresh herbs, 1 teaspoon dried herbs. For honey, 1 1/4 cup sugar plus 1/4 cup liquid. Okay? And for lemon zest, lemon zest is fresh lemon juice, 1/2 teaspoon lemon extract. For lemon juice, 1 teaspoon, 1/2 teaspoon vinegar. For lemongrass, 1 tablespoon of lemon peel. For oil, for sautéing, 1/4 cup melted margarine, butter, bacon drippings, and shortening or lard. For shortening, melted, 1 cup cooking oil. For tomato juice, 1½ cup tomato sauce plus 1½ cup water. For red wine, syempre, red wine is made up of grape, so pwedeng grape juice. For sugar, pwedeng honey. For white wine, pwedeng apple juice. And for white pepper, pwedeng black pepper. So sometimes you experience missing an ingredient and it is inconvenient to run out and purchase a similar product as a replacement. If a similar ingredient is unavailable, you can use substitutes. Mahirap yung tatakbo ka pa kung saan-saan, di ba? Just for the sake na bibili ka pa sa labas, eh paano kung nagmamadali ka lang, di ba? Okay, next. Let's discuss our activities for today. For activity 1, let's do ML, measure and learn. In this activity, you can use your knowledge about the right tool and procedures to properly measure the ingredients. Do your best to answer the following. Activity 1.1. Directions. Complete the following statements. Write your answer on the blank. When measuring, level off the dry ingredient using blank. Sift the refined sugar to remove the blank. Lean over and view the liquid at blank to make sure it is the proper amount. 1 stick of butter is equal to blank cup. Firmly press blank into the cup with the back of a spoon. Saan makikita ito, guys? Dun sa mga lectures. Okay, let's go to activity 1.2. Identify the best measuring tool that you can use to properly measure the following ingredients. Write the letter of the best answer on the space provided. Letter A, is it measuring spoon? Letter B, measuring cup for dry ingredients. Letter C, measuring cup for liquid ingredients. And letter D, is it measuring scale? So given here are 10 questions for you to answer. So let's go to the next activity 2. Next activity, this is activity 2. Substitution is the solution. Complete the table by writing the substitutes for the following ingredients. Make sure that your measurement is correct. Okay, so given naman yung mga measurements doon, paki-check nyo na lang. The ingredients are 2 tablespoon cornstarch. The next one is 1 cup barbecue sauce. Then 2 tablespoon of fresh herbs. Then 2 teaspoon lemon juice. And 1 cup butter. Then opposite that, isulat nyo yung substitute. Paki-check nyo yung ano ha, yung measurement ha. Baka mamaya nasa example natin, 1 cup ng barbecue sauce. So dodoblihin nilang siya. So remember, you should use the proper measuring tools to achieve accurate measurements. Inulit ko, no, pag sinabing accurate measurements, kailang eksakto. Walang nalabis, walang kukulang. Your final product made with the substituted ingredient may differ slightly from the original food. Correct. Diba? Sabi ko nga siya, hindi naman kasi yun yung original. Eh. Kumbaga sa pinroxy lang. Halimbawa, hindi ka makapunta sa isang handaan. Ano? Di pinadala mo yung kapatid mo bilang proxy. So, iba yung makakain niya sa makakain mo. Tsaka iba rin yung paghahalubilo niya sa paghahalubilo mo. Kasi ikaw naman talaga yung imbitado. And then, it will still be acceptable in flavor, texture, and appearance. So, okay, acceptable naman. So, the last one is measuring the ingredients is always fun. So, practice again your cooking skills and enjoy cooking. Now, checking your understanding, ito, ulit tayo, pwedeng sagutan ng Tagalog. Number one, why is it important to use the proper measuring tools? Bakit importante na gumamit ng tamang tools na pansukat? And how can measuring of ingredients affect your product? Paano makakapekto yung ingredients, maapekto ng ingredients nyo ng mga, maapekto yung product nyo nung ingredients na inilalagay nyo. Okay, yung tamang ingredients na inilalagay nyo. So post-test, guys, answer this. This will be checked. Checkan ko yan, ano? This is 1 to 10. And the last question for this lecture is, for this week is, How can this lesson help you in your family or daily life? Balik na naman tayo sa dati. Paano makakatulong ang lecture na natutunan nyo ngayon, ang mga bagay na natutunan nyo ngayon sa inyong sa pang-araw-araw nyong pamumuhay? Okay guys, that ends our topic for this week, and malamig na hapon sa inyong lahat. Ano, alam naman natin na bumabagyo. Always be safe, pray to the Lord, and